Work, work, all week long, punching that clock, dust till dawn, counting the days till Friday night, that's when all the conditions are right for a good time.
Hey guys, Tyson Anderson here, Mr. Hammer Down. We're right here with one of Raeford's own community legends. Listen guys, this Godwin store, Godwin's Outdoors, I believe it is, has been in existence for how long, Mr. Godwin?
Going on 40 years.
Going on 40 years, yes sir. So how exactly, I know you was just telling me briefly about you being ex-military, and I'll let you go ahead and how you got it started.
Yeah, I ex-military. Retired out in the Army, and about 30 years ago, I started buying pelts, fur, mostly raccoon, otter, bobcats, and the fur business went out, animal active, got rid of the fur business, so I started investing in hunting supplies.
Wow.
Started off with a pair of hip boots and a nightlight.
30 years ago.
30 years ago. And gradually we got where we at today.
Wow. Yeah. Wow. I'd say you guys have more outdoor stuff than anybody around. I mean, I just left from Dixon Field and Stream, and I'm telling you, like, they don't have half the stuff that you guys have. That's crazy, the inventory you guys have.
Well, we try to stay simple, really. Key on what the coon hunters, deer hunters, and trappers or whatever, their needs, got to keep their supply.
Wow, yes sir, yes sir. Well, you guys heard it from the gentleman himself, the establishmentarian of this great work. Listen guys, I'm gonna go through here and show you a quick tutorial of Godwin's Outdoors. If you get a chance, what is the address here, Mr. Godwin?
221 Ivy Street.
221 Ivy Street, Raeford, North Carolina. Listen, guys, stay tuned.
A few minutes later.
All right, guys, so quick addition. I went ahead and stopped the recording. I wanted to add his wife in, Miss Godwin here. Mr. Godwin said, listen, I want to make sure you put this in. Go ahead, Mr. Godwin, I'll let you go ahead.
Yeah, Miss Godwin, while I was in the military, she was the backbone of this business, keeping it going. Matter of fact, she's the one that started off with that one light, coon light from nightlight, and
whoop whoop,
and a pair of hip boots.
Wow, Miss Godwin, a very very humble lady, a few words, I tell you. But they have a great situation going on here, guys. You guys get down here. We're gonna say that address again. That address again is what is it?
215 Ivy Street.
215 Ivy Street. Raeford, North Carolina. Look, guys, stay tuned. Okay, guys, let's go on in here. Now, if it comes from fishing tackle, fishing rods, lures, buckets, hats, stuffings, rifle and shotgun cases, to your Field and Stream type of uplander equipment, BB guns, lunch boxes, coolers, coyote and fox chuck traps, even down to minnows. They have live minnows here, folks. It's pretty neat. Live minnows here. They got night crawlers, all the way down to your typical tags, gun cleaning equipment, you pretty much name it. Carhartt gloves, hunting vests, a dog vest for those that are hog hunters, collars and leashes galore. Listen, if you can think about it, they have it. It's the outdoor clothing, Carhartt, your Browning things, your trail cameras, anything you can think of, the Carhartt boots. Here they have a plethora, an extended sanctuary of boots.
I mean, I'm telling you, if you want it, they have it. Carhartt boots, lacrosse, muck boots, Irish setter, dry shods. Let me see, the Danners. I mean, pretty much anything. As you can see, the hall is extended. It goes all the way down there. They've got more dry shods, more muck boots, Wolverines. I mean, it's here. If you can think of it, they have it. The extra Tufts. I'm gonna continue to go around the store. Pull that closed. All these boot selections. It's pretty crazy. Very extensive selection. And the thing I like about them the most, they are so professional here. And there's nothing that you can find on your own. They can definitely assist you in doing that. They're always so eager to help and assist. As you can see, all of the different boots, I'm telling you, I mean, it's crazy. You need a dictionary to come in here and figure it all out. They have a huge inventory. We just left from Field & Stream. I was just telling them, Field & Stream and Dick's Sporting Goods, there's so many different things that they have there, but they do not have here. I mean, do not have there that they do have here. And that was so monumental to me. I mean, all the way down to the Carhartt bib overalls, all of the different colors, as you can see, the boots, all of the different throwover jackets, the hoodies. Like I said, again, vests. I mean, I haven't even walked all the way through the store yet. It is huge here. Huge selection. 215 Ivy Road, Raeford, North Carolina. I love these little mom and pop stores right here because there's such an essential feeling of sensation that just runs through my sides and run through my body, knowing that these people have came here. The Mrs. Godwin actually said that they came here. She has 5 children, and she just started this. Or they came up with the collaboration of this because they wanted to just keep food on the table for the children, and they were able to do so with this company, starting from pelts. Just think of that. Something so small. In its infancy, who would have ever known that something as small as pelts would have boomeranged and catapulted something as large and magnanimous as this right here? So paramount. People come from all over the place. Look at all these jeans, this extended collection of jeans. Like I said, Carhartt over and over and over again. I mean, as much as you can see, big and tall, slender man, the kid or youth and young adult, they have it. Here's where it really gets good. This is the juicy stuff for those avid hunters. You see, they have the 1 light and the 3 light raccoon helmets. They have the vest where you can, you know, I mean, pretty much everything. It's crazy. From the used collars to the, or gently used collars to brand new, from scopes to anything, I mean, that you can absolutely think of. It's unbelievable. I'm going to slide over here down to belts, slide over here and let you guys see some of those collars that they have. Look at this. If they don't have them, they can't be got. It's here. They have the walker tags. Coon hunters' wives do it too. I'm a coon hunter. I mean, they have the new Garmin's in, guys, just so you guys know. The Alpha 200s, the TT Minis. They had the T5 Minis. They had the Astro 430s, the Pro Trash Breakers. What is that? The Pro 550 Plus. Pretty much everything that you can think of. Again, here we have Miss Melissa, one of the store affiliates. There they are. This is Mr. Godwin's daughter, Miss Melissa right there. and the young lady, Miss Jada. They're camera shy right now, but when I cut the camera off, they're not like that. And like I said, they're rather professional, always eager to help and assist. If you buy any kind of Garmin product, they are more than willing and capable and able to assist you on to knowing your product better. They do not mind taking the time they've had. As Ms. Godwin told me, they have had people call in and actually have to be walked through the tutorial over the telephone on how to use that product. That is amazing. Some people that are Garmin vendors, they sell you a product and they don't really mind whether you learn how to use that product or not, but these individuals do. They go above and beyond the extra mile in making sure you do know how to use your product. And that right there is amazing, guys. So listen, Tyson Anderson, Mr. Hammerdown, when you get a chance, come on over to Godwin's Outdoors. Listen, 215 Ivy Road, Raeford, North Carolina. There's something going on in the city of Raeford, and I want you to be a part of it. I think the Godwins want you to be a part of it. Until next time, Tyson Anderson, Mr. Hammerdown. We'll see you when you get to Godwin's.
Well, I caught my wife with another man, and it cost me 99. On a prison farm in Georgia, close to the Florida line. Well, I've been here for 2 long years. I finally made the warden my friend. And so he sentenced me to a life of ease, taking care of old Red. Now old Red, he's the damnedest dog that I've ever seen. Got a nose that can smell a 2-day trail. He's a 4-legged tracking machine. You can consider yourself mighty lucky to get past the gators and the quicksand beds. But all these years that I've been here, ain't nobody got past Red. And the warden sang, come on somebody, why don't you run? Old Red's itching to have a little fun. Get my lantern, get my gun. Red'll have you treat for the morning come. Well, I paid off the guard and I slipped out a letter to my cousin up in Tennessee. Oh, and he brought down a blue tick hound. She was pretty as she could be. Well, they pinned her up in the swampland, about a mile just south of the gate. And I'd take old Red for his evening run. I'd just drop him off and wait. And the warden sang, come on somebody, why don't you run? Red's itching to have a little fun. Get my lantern, get my gun. Red'll have you treat for the morning come. Now old Red got real used to seeing his lady every night. And so I kept him away for 3 or 4 days and waited till the time got right. Well, I made my run with the evening sun and I smiled when I heard him turn red out. As I was headed north to Tennessee and old Red was headed south. And the warden sang, come on somebody, why don't you run? Old Red's itching to have a little fun. Get my lantern, get my gun. Red'll have you treat for the morning come. Now there's red-haired blue ticks all in the south. Love got me in here and love got me out.
Every time I think I smell that sweet southern rain, it takes me to a station on the long black train. I wanna hear the wind blow and feel the earth move below me. In spite of all the good times, I gotta rest my soul. So I'm gone. Yes, I'm gone. Gone to Carolina, where I know that I belong. Yes, I'm gone. Yes, I'm gone. Gone to Carolina, where I know I have a home. see your face in a crowd. It's like a bell inside of me, and it's ringing out loud. I've been so high for so long, there's nothing tried nor true. I'm thinking about coming down.